Alright. Welcome back, everyone, to Islands of Adventure. I just got off riding Harry Potter and the Forbidden Journey. Ride looks like it's in pretty good shape right now. Pretty much all the effects are working except for the fog screen that projects the Dementor's Kiss at the end of the ride. That's kind of a minor effect and is always in and out. So now we're going to take a walk out of the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, walk into Jurassic Park, see what's going on in Jurassic Park, and then climb up into Camp Jurassic so we can see some construction on Skull Island, Reign of Kong. Weather's starting to warm up a little. It's getting up into the higher 50s. It might turn out to be a nice day. Say goodbye to Hogwarts. Always a beautiful sight. Alright, now let's head on into Jurassic Park. Discovery Center doesn't open until 10 a.m., but the gift shop is open. Morning. So quiet in here. It's kind of sad to see how the store used to carry a lot of educational things and books, and now it's just all toys. Squirrel! 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 Raptor Encounter has become really, really popular. They usually don't start till about 11 a.m., but you want to get in line at least a half hour before the first session if you want to see it. Oh, you were? What department were you with? I was here at opening for entertainment production. You want to play any games? Now's the time. There's no one here. Only a 5-minute wait for River Adventure. Can't imagine why when it's 50 degrees out. See if anyone's brave enough to be riding River Adventure. Oh, someone's coming out of their wet. Yeah, I remember first few times I came into IOA with hard hat and work boots. Remember when Lost Continent was just mud, and going in to test the Mythos menu. It was back in the day when they served lobster there. Oh, I miss that. That sounds like a nice breakfast. They must only have a couple boats on the river because the long gap between drops here. We'll wait for a second to see if the boat comes down. Wow, there are a total of 3 people on that boat. I can certainly understand why. Temperature, we're heading up into the mid-50s right now. It's still pretty chilly for Orlando. This is what we call Florida cold. Anywhere else in the country it would be like early spring, but here it's winter. It looks like only a 10-minute wait for Trononon Flyers if you can kidnap a small child to take on the ride with you. And this slide is still closed off. They've been doing maintenance. I'm going to be charitable and say they've been doing maintenance, but a lot of stuff here in Camp Jurassic has been sealed off for a while. And I haven't really seen any progress being made. Alright, let's go up to the top of Camp Jurassic and see how construction is coming along. Skull Island. So this is Skull Island, Reign of Kong, next to Jurassic Park and Island's Adventure. No official opening date has been announced yet. I'm hearing anything from April to June, hopefully sooner rather than later. As for what the ride is going to be like, it's not a recreation of the old King Kong ride, and it's not exactly like the Kong that they have in Hollywood right now. It's going to be an indoor-outdoor dark ride with very large truck-like vehicles, sort of like the Kilimanjaro safaris. It's going to be a mix of giant show scenes with practical effects and animatronics, and also 3D effects like they use in the studio tour in Hollywood. It's going to be massive from what I'm hearing. You can get a sense of scale. There's a construction worker right there. Look at the size of that building. From what I hear, testing is going on really well inside the attraction. Ride vehicles are cycling. Kong animatronic is on site and being tested. So, looks like they're in good shape. Right now I'm standing on the highest tower in Camp Jurassic, which is the kids' play area in Jurassic Park. It looks out over the construction site. Thank you for visiting Camp Jurassic. And that right there is going to be the entrance to Kong. It's looking pretty good. Like I just said, they haven't announced an opening date for Kong. Sometime this spring, before early summer. They're saying summer 2016. Could be anywhere between April and June. Alright guys, thanks for watching along. I may Periscope one more time in a few minutes. Keep an eye on our Twitter feed. Alright, welcome back everyone. My battery situation's getting kind of desperate, so it looks like this will be my last Periscope of the morning. We're gonna walk from Port of Entry and Islands of Adventure through Seuss Landing over to Hogsmeade, and then take the Hogwarts Express train ride from Islands of Adventure over to Diagon Alley in Universal Studios, Florida. Hope everyone's having a great day. Weather here is starting to clear up a little. It was really cold when I got here this morning, but now it's not too bad. We're pushing up into the 60s. We're gonna hit the low 70s a little later this afternoon. And it looks like it's staying dry for now. I love this musical transition here as we go under the bridge. Now let's go take a look at the wait time board and see what the waits are like around the park. We're looking at 5 minutes for all of the Seuss attractions, 25 minutes for Dr. Doom, 30 for Spider-Man. That's alright, 30 for Spider-Man, 5 minutes for Ripsaw Falls, so a little chilly for that. Half an hour for Forbidden Journey or Fly the Hippogriff. Looks like I'm only going to have about a 10-minute wait for the train, so let's go check it out. Oh, by the way, anyone see anything missing? Where'd the Hulk's track go? No, wait, we got a... hold on, we got a little activity over here. Looks like we've got some vaguely Middle Eastern silt walkers. Yeah, the Hulk has been torn down and is being rebuilt, and it will be back in operation this summer. Can't wait to ride it again, have it be nice and smooth the way it was back in 1999. Let's take a little look across the lagoon here. Once upon a time, there was an attraction called Island Skipper Tours, and you would board a little boat from here, take it across the water. Of course, that's long, long gone. There's Hogwarts across the water. Mythos Restaurant. And Seuss Landing. Now let's take a little walk through Seuss. anyone want to hijack a submarine? Not sure it'll still work, but hey, let's try. Yeah, there's the queue line for the abandoned attraction. It's very interesting that Animal Kingdom and Islands Adventure both opened within a year of each other, and they both have almost identical abandoned attractions. You've got the Discovery Boats at Animal Kingdom and the Jungle Skipper Tours at Islands Adventure. Both were transportation boat rides that were supposed to take you across to the other side of the park. And both were shut down because people thought it was a real attraction and would line up for hours and then realized that it was just taking them around the park. And there wasn't really much to it. Very high guest dissatisfaction numbers because of that. So because of capacity and low entertainment value, they were both shut down at both parks. And you can still see remnants of them to this day. You can see another boat dock over between Jurassic Park and Harry Potter here at Islands Adventure. And over at Animal Kingdom, next time you're there, keep an eye out. They generally use them for meet and greets. There are several of them scattered around Discovery Island. We're looking at only a 5-minute wait for Cat in the Hat. I like One Fish, Two Fish, but I think the ride needs a good paint job. Only a 5-minute wait for that one, too. This is where the Grinchmas show, where you enter the Grinchmas show when that's running. Unfortunately, that closed early in the new year. I'll have to wait until next December for that to come back. This is interesting. So the sign for the Oh, the Stories You Hear show is way over here. I'm guessing they're performing it over here this week. Not really sure why. Let me see if I can ask around. This is a fun little bookstore. Wow, and there's absolutely no one at home. Anybody home? Oh. Oh, hi.
Hi.
Hey, I got a question. I noticed the sign out there. Did they move the show from that
here.
Inside?
No, right here.
Oh, do you have any idea why?
I think they're getting more traffic in here than over there.
Oh, wow. Okay. Mm-hmm. Is it how long that's been going on for?
About a week.
Oh, about a week. All right, cool. Thank you. All right, it looks like that Sioux show moved about a week ago. So let's keep an eye on that. Check that on the map. Only about a 10-minute wait for the Sioux trolley right now. Say goodbye to Seuss. Goodbye, Seuss. Let's head into the Lost Continent.
y'all stop.
If you haven't eaten in Mythos lately, late last year they swapped out the menu. They've got a new executive chef trying to do some more authentic Greek and Mediterranean dishes. To be honest, I love authentic Mediterranean food. I haven't been thrilled with a lot of the new things I've tried. I appreciate that they're testing out new things. Keep an eye on it, but that sign still really needs to come down. I did. I had a hot butter beer with a shot of fire whiskey for breakfast. That's all that's keeping me going at this point. Decided to put a Dipping Dots cart here. Hello. So if you want a good alternative to burgers and chicken fingers when you're here in the park, this is one of my favorite places, Doc Sugre's Desert Kebab House. Beef and chicken kebabs are really good. Hummus is also really nice. Give it a try sometime.
Well, bye, girls. You have fun, Candy, Sandy, and Sam. They got water. Oh my goodness. You have to be from Boston because this is like huge weather.
My name is Kevin, and I'm from California.
All right.
Kevin from California.
And I'm Bob.
And you are Bob. You're little Bob. I'm gonna call you Bobby Sue. I knew you were from Boston. You got a Bruins shirt on. Go Bruins!
Bye,
bye, kids. Have fun.
Bye. You're
and you're short.
Hello. How are you? Great. Do you know what's going on with the construction walls right out here?
I have no idea.
They don't tell you anything.
I ask and they go,
it's something. You'll come in one day and find the building's been knocked down. Oops, sorry. Bulldozer. Have a great afternoon. I really love that shop. Hulk's going to open up this summer. They haven't set an exact date yet. All right, now we are back at Hogsmeade. Welcome back to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. Hey, let's go take a ride on the Hogwarts Express. Hello.
Hey there, how you doing?
I'm great, how are you?
I'm doing wonderful. You are all set
Thank
to
you
go.
So much.
You're very welcome.
Have a great day.
You too.
Nice hat.
Thank you. Pardon me.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. Yeah, it's nice. It's going to pick up a little this afternoon as it warms up, but, you know, this is mid-January on a weekday. It's kind of famous for being one of the slower times of year. So now we are walking through the Hogsmeade train station for the Hogwarts Express. And it looks like we'll be on a train in just a few minutes. Hello.
Hey, is this you? You're right down this way, sir.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Hi, sir. Just one. Okay, you added a run number 4, please.
Thank you. Ooh. Looks like I may get a cabin all to myself. Hi, New Jersey. Here comes the train. Mexico. Thank you. Wow, it looks like I'm getting the whole cab to myself. Awesome. The attention to detail in these things is really great. Down to the pictures. The upholstery. We need the heater on today, maybe.
Welcome aboard. Just make sure you stay seated and enjoy your trip.
Thank you. All right, here we go. This is the first time I've been here completely on my own. One of the cool things is that even if you look all the way up against the window, you can't see the edge of the screen. The screen is curved slightly so that you can't see the ends of it no matter where you look. It's pretty neat. No, that's all video projection. My pleasure, thanks for watching. Now I will say this is taking a little longer than normal. Here we go! Yay, we're off. Yeah, the train is actually moving and you feel the rumbling under your seat. Alright, here's a neat thing. As you come out, you're looking all the way on the far end. You can just see the front of the train all the way at the edge of the window. It's really hard to see. You have to have your face right up against the glass. It's a neat little trick to try. Definitely CGI. It's probably about as good as the CGI in the movies, which means it's okay.
Oh, number five is getting
late.
Let me catch you now. Purchase. No, you're
pretty
kind, right? Did you really have to do that?
Honestly, Rob, let us please.
Yes, the silhouettes on the windows are also projections. Thank you. Hey, thanks for taking that train ride with me. Stick around. We're going to take a quick little walk through Diagon Alley and then loop around the park. Did a periscope of the Hogwarts castle earlier this morning. Right now we're going to walk through Diagon Alley, take a look at Gringotts. Thank you. We just left Hogsmeade and arrived in London, Diagon Alley. Say hi to the night bus. Oh, it looks like there's a little bit of a line to get a picture with the conductor. Yes, I have had hot butter beer, cold butter beer, frozen butter beer, butter beer ice cream. They just introduced butter beer fudge. I have not tried that yet. And I believe there's also a butter beer pudding. I'm falling a little behind. You need to catch up on my butter beers. Alright, this is some sort of miracle. Gringotts is still saying it's only a 10-minute wait. Poke our head inside the bank. See what it looks like inside.
Hey guys.
Entra. Hey guys, I'm back to Luis Articles in a free locker.
Line is still going straight into the bank. Pretty neat, huh? Thanks. This is one of my favorite little spots in Diagon Alley. We call these the stairs to nowhere. You walk to the top, you can see that the buildings at the very top are forced perspective. They've been scaled down to look bigger than they are. And then you get a really cool view from up here. Alright, unless there's anything specific in Diagon Alley that someone wants me to take a look at, I'm gonna hop out and do a little loop around the park before I head home. We can walk through Nocturne Alley on the way. Thank you so much. Alright guys, don't get scared. We're going into Nocturne Alley. It's a little spooky, I know. See what the wait times are like in the rest of the park. Oh, Terminator doesn't start till noon today. That's late. Despicable Me is up to almost an hour. Rip Ride Rocket, 30 minutes. Transformers, an hour. Everything else is 10 minutes. Gringotts, that's listed at 15 now. Simpsons, 15. It's really amazing. It's a nice, quiet day to be in the park unless you want to go ride Despicable Me. Then it's busy. This always amazes me. I believe this is the last, well, maybe one of the last working payphones. Anyone want to dial it? 407-351-4108. The Jaws skippers used to play pranks with that phone all the time when they got bored. Well, Fear Factor is back again, for better or for worse. Hello, Russia. Now we're walking up on Men in Black. We got people from all over here today. Hello, UK. Ooh, flip the camera there for a second. Sorry about that. The rumors were true. RoboAsus, the little Coca-Cola display, they filed a notice of commencement to demolish it and rebuild it. Looks like it's finally happening. Thank God. The thing was in terrible, terrible shape. What's going on over the Simpsons? Hello. Do you know if both domes are running, or which is the one that just got refreshed?
There's people coming out of this one, so probably this way.
Okay.
They're all walking, so.
Okay, so one of them's been upgraded, and the other one they're going to work on.
This one they're still doing some work on it. But
Can you tell the difference with the projector? You haven't been on it yet. All right, I'll give it a try. Thank you. All right, I'm going to go ride the Simpsons. See if it's looking any better since the projector worked. Looks like I might be stuck here for a little while, so I'm going to save my battery and sign off. Thanks to everyone for watching, I really appreciate the support, and keep an eye on our Twitter feed, because we're going to try to be periscoping some more real soon. Have a great day.